Get your special horoscope for the year ahead 2020 at NadiyaShah.com. Hello, fabulous superstar Cancer. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of January 2020. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. And it is a very big month for you. So on the one hand, we do have that conglomerate of planets, as I'm calling it, in your opposite sign. Most notably, we do have Saturn and Pluto meeting in your opposite sign. This is truly once in a lifetime for you that you are going to see something like this. But the other layer is that there are a lot of other planets joining Saturn and Pluto as well, amping up its potential to bring developments for you where it comes to another person, to your awareness, to your understanding, and very likely another person becoming almost consuming to you at this time. But here's the thing. One thing that we also have is a lunar eclipse in your sign under the same sky. So the lunar eclipse will take place in your sign right around the 10th of the month. And even though these connections that Saturn and Pluto and the Sun and Mercury are making all happen between the eclipse and right around the 12th, like that is sort of the golden period, if you will, when most of what is going to be most important to you is taking place. So the perfection of the conglomerate takes place right around the 12th. The lunar eclipse in your sign will bring to an end eclipse season. And it is going to be this eclipse in your sign that is set to be truly defining in important ways. You are going to have another eclipse in your sign in the middle of the year, but by then the nodes will have left your sign. The north node rather will have left your sign, which means that this is when the eclipse is at the height of its power in a way that it will not be again. When it is that eclipses take place in your sign, well, it tends to represent a shift in identity, a new perception of self. And for you, a part of what changes now is an understanding of where it is that you are ready to bring a chapter to a close. And it may very well be that your interaction with another person is very much a part of what does change for you now from the inside out. Now remember, all of this is so that you can align with a higher, more loving vision for your life, so that you can live more fully than you have before, so that you can acknowledge where it is that you have changed and to allow yourself to make those changes, to get in touch with what is true for you and what it means to live your truth more fully. You know, very often it is the case that part of what causes us distress or discomfort or depression, and I'm not speaking necessarily about chemical issues that can take place in the brain. I have absolute respect for that. And if it is that you have any kind of clinical depression taking place, it's a really good idea to connect with your physician to talk about it and to get medical advice. But outside of that, when I look at it from a spiritual perspective, right, which can be taken as an addition to what's happening on a medical level, and when you just look at not necessarily what's happening with depression, but sort of a malaise, if you will, as you move through the world, very often what happens is that there is a deeper truth that is more difficult to look at, more difficult to acknowledge. There is a deeper desire to experience a different life. And it is in being able to at least acknowledge that and being willing to, in however way, align with that, that we're able to start bringing ourselves out of what otherwise could be quite difficult moments, difficult transitions. Regardless of where you are with that, if you are one of the Cancers out there that feels like your life is really good, you're happy, all is well, then this moment of truth that does show up for you might be a little bit more subtle, but no less important. It may very well be the truth that shows up for you is about helping you to move towards greater happiness and a greater fulfillment than you knew before. But if it is that you truly are at a space where you know you could be feeling better, well, it is going to be this eclipse that helps you to understand what that requires and what that means for you. I actually really love eclipses, even eclipses like this. Like I said, there may be an interaction with another person that is challenging, but it is ultimately meant to get you in touch with your own power, with your own truth, and with your own desire to understand how to create a more stable inner life that will benefit every area of your life going forward. And in this way, this time is defining. But what I love about eclipses is that they are about truth, and ultimately they align you with greater love and greater wisdom than you knew before. Perhaps greater love and greater wisdom than you realized you could align with before, until you are in alignment with it. It is now that as your identity goes through some moment of truth, some shift, some change, as you own what it is that is true for you, what you really feel about an area that is close to you, well, it is then, as you look at things honestly, that you also find the courage and the strength and the clarity to make changes and to move yourself in a more enlightened, in a more positive, in a more honest, in a more authentic direction. And in this way, I truly feel of all the zodiac out there, you are one of the most lucky. There might be strong emotions, yes, but it is in allowing ourselves to feel that we truly live. And it is through the feelings that we connect with spiritual truths about ourselves. And it is in that space of truth that we are able to embody and live it that much more. And that is the truest definition of living fully in alignment with greater love and greater wisdom. So as I said, relationships, partnerships may very much be a part of this. I think this is going to be an important month on that front with the conglomerate of planets taking place. There is set to be a moment of honesty for you. If you're open to meeting someone new, well, chances are you'll be gaining valuable insights into where you are in love and why. It's possible you might have already connected with someone late last month with the solar eclipse that we had. And this is ultimately part of helping you to reach that deeper layer of truth. If you're just starting to get to know someone, this is going to be a sense of what might really be going on with this person on a deeper level than you knew before. And it is in this sense of it's a clarity, but it's emotional. It's not a mind level clarity. It's not an aha moment, but rather, as Oprah would call it, but rather it is about truly digging deep within you and admitting to yourself what it is that this person is showing you about whom it is that they are. And in being willing to acknowledge that, to see it, it is there that you're able to learn that much more about yourself and where it is that you want to move forward, where it comes to love, with or without this person. And for those of you in an established bond, I think that this is going to be a time of reflection, of understanding where it is that your partner reflects you and where you are. So whether that is reflects you in terms of your self-esteem and self-worth, whether that is reflecting certain attributes about you, certain habits about you. And it is in that space that you're able to understand more fully the dynamic between the two of you. Now, for some, this can be a time when your partner asks you to be better in some way and is part of what helps to lift you up and lift you forward. It is possible now that as a result of an interaction with your partner, you realize where it is that you could be loving yourself more. Now, as you can imagine, this can happen in a couple of different ways. Sometimes it is often the case, you know, I hear people say you have to love yourself before you can love someone else. But the truth is, it does happen in life quite a bit, actually. I've seen it, where we connect with someone who loves us, and thereby we are able to understand what it means to love ourselves more than we did before. They show us the way to love ourselves more deeply because of the love that they give to us. And so this may very well be one of those moments for you, but it can also go the other way as well, where it could be that you realize where it is that there have been compromises that maybe aren't working for you. And then that shows you where the work is within your established bond to move yourselves towards greater honesty and greater commitment going forward from here. Now, Having said all of that, and with this very intense mid-month cycle taking place for you, we've got some other things happening in the sky. Let me just quickly mention, mainly that is the new moon right around the 24th. You will have a new moon taking place in a part of the sky for you that has to do with a few different things. So on the one hand, this part of the sky is connected to transformation and regeneration. It is connected to you understanding where you've been and where it is that you are now ready to go, where it is that you are now ready to head, and what parts of you are going to be left behind, consciously so. Because it is that Uranus is speaking to this part of the sky in a conversation of tension, well, it does suggest that some of what shows up for you, perhaps through people you know, perhaps through friends, is part of the surprise that shows you what it is that really is within you, that shows you where it is that you are ready to transform, where it is that you are ready to change. Keep in mind, Chiron is also speaking in harmony with this new moon, so where it is that you are pursuing your career goals or alignment with life purpose, you bring in healing energy, and it may very well be in the pursuit of these larger goals that you end up realizing where it is you've changed, or you end up experiencing a moment that feels like a regenerative and transformative moment for you. But this part of the sky is also connected to your relationship with financial institutions, and there are some Cancerians out there who may very well experience this as a time when you're having to very quickly and perhaps surprisingly pay attention to matters related to a financial institution. And so I would say with this energy, if anybody out there should not be mixing friends and money, you would be one of those signs right about now. But the great potential and possibility and excitement of this is that you have this real sense now of momentum and of excitement, a real sense now that you are moving in a direction of being a different you, and in a way that you really like, you know, realizing what has served its purpose and where it is now that you are moving forward, and where it is that you are ready to understand wealth and how wealthy you are, where it is that you're ready to own your power to move towards greater prosperity. Well, it is going to be this energy that helps you to do just that. In fact, for some Cancerians out there, you may attract a large sum of money in the assistance of the achievement of a larger goal. But for all that, keep in mind that where it comes to your association, your alignment with other people, well, that's when we start tapping into an energy that says it is possible very quickly. You have to pay attention to what's happening with a credit card or with a loan or with your mortgage, but whatever shows up, you'll deal with it. It will represent a moment and you will move forward. That's not a likely scenario for most Cancerians out there, but it is worth mentioning. Sometimes the universe asks you to pay attention to financial matters as a reminder that the money you need is there. And with a sky like this, you absolutely are abundant. There's more than enough money available to you. It is about you just showing up for it, doing the work that's in front of you to do, to navigate your spiritual lessons. And it is in that process that you will come to understand how wealthy you are. What I love about this month for you, well, there's a lot here, but I am going to say that eclipse that is happening in your sign is a really big deal. Now, it is going to be Uranus that under the same sky is going to go direct. So that adds to the strength, it adds to the awakening of this time. But this is a lunar eclipse. It is rooted in emotion, and what your truth and what your awareness is very likely is going to be on deeper, more emotional channels. But that's part of what makes this time so rewarding. It is you having a deeper knowing about what your truth is, your emotional and subjective truth. And it is in connecting with that truth that you find the courage and the excitement to more fully live it. Well, thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for 2020 special horoscope previews that are coming up right now. And you can get a video like this every week by logging on to NadiyaShah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded exclusive videoscopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy. Hello, fabulous superstar Cancer. Welcome to your 2020 special horoscope. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. What an amazing year it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. And in any given year, there are a lot of different transits, a lot of different celestial moments to take into consideration. But a year like this is just so active. And for you, the larger theme that begins to play out this year, it has to do with fundamental and deep transformation from the inside out. This is about you consciously deciding what stays and what goes, who you are, but also whom it is that you are not. And in this way, 2020 can be a truly consequential time, or at the very least, the beginning of an important cycle where you are digging deep within you. In the process, you will come to understand more deeply what it means to be well.